welcome tonight to my show here on CKTV YouTube. I'm here tonight to bring you the preview, a preview 2 weeks out from its out on the Xbox 360 and the PlayStation 3, and a month out from the big release on the next gen consoles, the Xbox One and the Xbox and the PS4. So it's really, really heating up as WWE 2K15 is concerned, made by, of course, 2K Sports, and it's really the first game that they totally took control of. Remember last year, the 2K done WWE 2K14, and it was a pretty big deal, great game. They concentrated on the 3 years of WrestleMania mode and all, and the streak mode, which was a bit of a disappointment, but overall, it had the best roster of all time, you could argue. And the DLC was very good as well. I talked about it in the last preview video for 2K15, about it being, of course. And I also done a review recently of WWE 2K14, a video review. And a few months earlier, I done a video review of the DLC. Of course, the DLC included the NWO pack and the WWF Legends pack. But right now, tonight, I'm going to cover some analysis and opinions and the preview of WWE 2K15, and a lot of people have mixed opinions of the game. You could argue that it's been very much held back from the viewers, from the fans. I don't think it's been endorsed enough. There's not enough info being put out there. I think you may all agree that. A lot of hype about it. The trailer, which you see at the top of the show, has been just released about a couple of ago. Very impressive trailer, very realistic. We've seen some footage, but we've seen some. And the gameplay is really realistic. I think it's very authentic looking. Look at the past games and compare them to really get that, but it really has a real life-like kind of feeling about it. We've seen the trailer recently of the Wyatt family, which is one of the newer teams in wrestling, and really, really realistic. Really eerie video, and on the actual shows itself, the real shows, the Wyatt family are the most eerie group in a long time in wrestling. Great gimmicks, great characters, but they come into 2K15 this year for the first time, and it's really, really cool. But the game in general is looking very, very prosperous. I'm hoping the creation system is just as good as 2K14 was. Everybody's saying that as a 2K follower that, oh, you better watch, you know, the creation system might be as good, because the NBA games never have a great creation system. Also, you have the face scan technology in this game. Not something I'd be big into, but other people will be big into themselves in the game and stuff. I'd be just looking to get old school legends from the different eras and companies to put into the game. But I definitely think that 2K15 is looking good as far as. There is others saying as well on the Legends forum and that, which I follow, there's a few people saying that the 2K15 will be like the Legends. They say that the creations will be even better because it's not, remember last year we had 100 creation slots for this. And last year as well, with 100, with the animated arena slots. Will that go down to bring for other things in the next gen? Who knows? Very, very interesting to speculate over about next gen consoles and the games. They say that the game will be overhaul this year. You know, there's been some 60-something wrestlers announced in the game. There has been DLC just announced recently, that in a wee while. Coming up,
on the show, we're going to talk about the lack of legends in the roster. It could be a lot better. We have Hulk Hogan from the 2002-2003 era. We have Sting, of course, the DLC incentive, pre-order game incentive. He would be great. You had the Endo in there as well, and you had a few different. But the strange thing they've done now, they've announced the DLC, and the DLC includes a WCW pack. And in the WCW pack, they have Diamond Age, Bam Bam Bigelow, they have Finlay, Fit Fin, they have Lord Steven Regal, and they have one or two others. I was saying to myself, you know, that's not great. That's not exactly what I would call a DLC pack. They have Lex Luger as well. Lex Luger probably first, because he probably, him and DDP and Bam Bam would have been the most likable of them entries in DLC. But I would have thought they should bring in the NWO. But now the roster has not been announced, so who knows, the NWO could be in there as part of the normal roster. We know Kevin Nash is in the game. We know Hulk Hogan's in the game as NWO Hogan. And of course, two other eras of Hogan, the 80s, 90s era Hogan, and the, of course, the 2002-2003 Ruthless Aggression era Hogan. But it really is looking prosperous. The game, we could, I think we could see it, wrestling game for sure. A lot of things said about it over the last days.
Say that it will be, there'll be a showcase mode every year. There has been
five rivalries announced for this year's, so far this year, but it could be DLC throughout the year, which is very exciting for wrestling fans because we never got that before with TA2, so that's pretty prosperous. The Dino that has been announced for WWE 2015 is
were announced first, and they were like, meh, who cares about them? There were like two recent rivalries between, one between Randy Orton and Christian, and the other Hall of Pain, which was about Mark Henry's Hall of Pain gimmick throughout 2011. So they were both rivalries from 11. Everyone expected Rock, Stone Cold, or Orton, Cena, but what a game when you get first the CM Punk rivalry from back in 2012,
then of course the Triple H Shawn rivalry from the Ruthless Aggression era, 2002 through 2004. But the new one now, the new big one that I'm very interested in, is Path of the Warrior. Now that delves into old school right there, and we have a few names here that I'm going to basically name the path we're going to get. We're going to have the match from SummerSlam 1988, where the Warrior beats the Honky Tonk Man for the Intercontinental title. We're going to have the match from the Warrior versus Andre the Giant from Saturday night's main event. So that arena will be added into the game as well. Every arena from these matches are added into the game as well. So it's great to see some arenas get in the game as default, rather than you having to create some of these arenas. Also, we get the Madison Square Garden arena. We get the other arenas such as WrestleMania 6, 7, 12, and other arenas in the Golden Era. Warrior DLC also includes, the story also includes DLC like Andre the Giant, Colonel Mustafa, Sergeant Slaughter, General Adnan, Sid Justice, Jimmy Hart, Bobby the Brain Heenan, Sensational Sherry, the Macho King Randy Savage. So it'll be interesting to get the Macho King character in the game. As well as that, we will get the likes of teams from the World of Wrestling, such as Hulk Hogan. We have him anyway in the game. Some great names in this, but the strange thing about it is we have got so many more legends. There's been a very lack of legends. I would say that you would agree maybe that they're trying to spread out different legends, different years, but I think without them being all in the game together, it's kind of strange. You can't play that era properly. But I would say we might get another 5 to 10 legends in the on roster, because the full main roster has been named yet, but it will be great to get more. I would like to see Mr. Perfect, Roddy Piper, and the likes of Jake the Snake Roberts, Dusty Rhodes, and Superfly Jimmy Snuka, just to name a few. I would like to see them added into the game. Maybe a couple of tag teams, Legion of Doom and Demolition, would deserve a shot at this game as well. But who knows what way it'll go with 2K15. Let's just go to a trailer now. This is one of the other in the game, and a couple of clips right now. Here we go.